Today we're looking at alternate wetting and drying of rice. Typically in Arkansas, we plant our rice fields dry, and then at the 4 or 5 leaf growth stage, we apply a permanent flood across the whole field and maintain that flood until it's time to drain for harvest. Researchers have done work that have shown that you can drain the rice at certain growth stages and it doesn't hurt the yield.
We're at our family farm here in central Arkansas in Humnoke County. We grow about 3,500 acres of rice. One of the practices we implement here on the farm is AWD, which stands for alternate wetting and drying. And it's an irrigation practice wherein instead of leaving the soil completely inundated throughout the season, we'll allow it to dry up somewhat in the middle of the summer. We often think of soil as an inert ingredient, but in fact, it's alive. If you've ever been by anything that's swampy, that once you have organic matter or plant matter in a soil and you inundate it with water, there could be methane coming from that.
Alternate wetting and drying is a great practice. It has three main benefits. It conserves water, and then if you're pumping less water, you're conserving energy. It breaks that cycle of methane production that comes from rice.
NRCS has been a great resource to us as we've tried to advance our conservation practices through the years. In recent years, it's been very helpful as we've tried to implement practices like AWD and nutrient management and things that help us use less fertilizers, less water, and try to benefit the environment.